Hey guys, Austin here today. Yes, today we are back with another episode. As you can see, we are at the Jaguars. Maybe. But yeah, we're gonna pick our side activity again. We did it in the last episode, so we gotta see what we get. Okay, that's a nice thing to do, actually. You don't need that many pair of shoes. Like, how are you gonna wear like 20 of them in a week? I should have questioned that, actually. Prepare for the rain. No thanks.
Listen, conditions are gonna be wet and windy this weekend because of the hurricane coming in. And even if it doesn't hit directly, we're getting those out of bounds. Probably not going to put the ball in the air as much. So, you got to make the most of your chances.
You best stay dry. When it's raining, you are buggered. Like one raindrop, and yeah, you are
dry. Back now on EA Sports, and this being Florida, the weather here this time of year, unpredictable to say the least. These two teams returning from what was almost an hour-long delay in this third quarter. And we'll resume with an important play coming up, a third and short in a 14-6 ball game. Following the fumble recovery, Whitaker. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And this is going to be intercepted. Baker with a pick. And the Cardinals are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up.
Tell me about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach. That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
but
up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game.
Be aggressive
because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Well, we'll see what his offense can do. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Being chased out left. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. Decent gain on the scramble to six, but now it's four. Here's Andy Lee now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. Dorsett on the return. A nice punt, but a good run back as well, 13 yards. And the Jaguars go first down and 10. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. They begin the drive with Robinson. Oh, he's got some breathing room. There he goes, left side. Touchdown, Jaguars.
Yes.
James Robinson, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars are able to get a score back in the final stages of this third quarter. So there, Charles, I mean, a situation where it didn't matter how far he had to run, he was not going to be denied, and he winds up taking this all the way to the end zone. So the Jags will keep the offense out there as they'll decide to go for two. Flushed out right, and he'll get in the end zone as the two-point conversion is successful. And that was the old QB one-man band play there in the conversion.
And look, let's face it, even quarterbacks who don't have great mobility, in certain situations, they're able to actually take the ball in themselves. Remember way back when Joe Namath against the Giants at the Yale Bowl, right? Remember Joe had all those knee uprights, they thought he couldn't run it? No one accounted for him. He practically walked into the end zone.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. On the return, Andy Isabella. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And he's going to be stopped here for no gain. That's going to take us to the end of the third quarter play. We've played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Jacksonville. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. From the gun, Murray. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Sidney Jones.
Yes,
and he will take this one home. It's a touchdown.
And we are up to win.
In a tie game, fourth quarter, that's about as big of a defensive play as you can possibly make.
And it didn't happen by accident. That was scouting right there. They've seen things that have happened before. They knew in certain situations the type of plays they like to run. Read it, and were able to go after the football, get it, and take it into the end zone for a touchdown for themselves.
Footing always a concern, but the extra points up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And can they regroup? That's the question. The pick six hurt, no doubt, but this is still a one-score game here in the fourth. And the Jags get to him as down he goes. Devon Hamilton. Never giving up. He works his way to the QB for a loss of 12. A huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. It's the Pro Bowl quarterback, Richard Sherman. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. That's about as tough as they come. You're driving to try to put the ball in the end zone and tie the game, and that happens.
It's exciting for us, wasn't it? Because we were thinking, hey, we might be headed towards overtime. Instead, it looks like this one may very well be done. And guess what? If you're a fantasy owner and you have that defense, you just had a big, big game, didn't you?
Lambeau to add on the extra point.
We're not going to risk it.
He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. Play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. We'll see if they can band back together after the pick six. It hurt badly, but still within striking distance. A two-score game with a good chunk of time on the clock. And they'll begin by running the option. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively.
On second and 11 now, Murray. And my goodness, another interception. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. Seven picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offense coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll run here with Robinson. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Touchdown, Jaguars. James Robinson, the second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jags are closing in on a third straight victory to start the campaign. But quite a comeback here. Remember when that weather delay hit, they were sitting on just 6 points, but all that electricity seemed to wake them up somehow. As they've come back, they've gotten that offense in gear.
And I think you and I need to tap into that energy.
Oh, look at this. A flip to the kicker. He's going to try to run for it.
Well, I have to admit, I'm scratching my head a little bit here trying to make sense of what I just saw. Number one, huge lead. Just kick the extra point and be done with it. Number two, if you are going to go for two, just line up and go for it from the 2-yard line. Why make it so difficult? That's a long way to go to try and pick up some points.
Set to return it. Here's Moore. He takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
It's going to want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete. Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Again, they'll throw with Murray. And a catch made by Hopkins. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Meanwhile, Murray's throw put in by Hopkins. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. That catch, by the way, kind of noteworthy. It's number 764 in his career. Ties him with Hall of Famer James Lofton.
And he's done it just as James Lofton did in his career. Smooth.
And that is incomplete. Wow, the coverage a little too good there. And it's second down.
Well,
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over him, and they got there to break that one up.
On the screen, this is Edmonds. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. So they'll wind up losing 5 yards on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. Murray to air it out again. And now here's another interception. Shaquille Griffin with a pick. And the Jags are going to get the football here. At the 40-yard line. Yet another interception. I just have to double check my math. But it is now back between last week and this one.
I just used a calculator. I didn't worry about double checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard, and they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. Again, if you're just joining us and wondering why this game is still going on, we were delayed 55 minutes in the third quarter due to lightning in the area. The teams went back to the locker rooms. Fans were asked to seek shelter in the concourse, but we're back going again and still on the air. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. He sets to fire deep. And an incomplete, nearly intercepted. And remember, he had his hands on one earlier, had one pick. Could have been his second, but instead it's fourth down. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. And the Cardinals getting set to trot out there now. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
that's all that's left because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. And incomplete on the deep ball.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead in fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Murray looks to throw again, second and 10.
Get out of here.
And this will be swung out here for counter. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Shotgun now from Murray. He's going to let it fly. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the running Richard Sherman. And the Jaguars are going to get the football back at their own 17. Gosh, you add up last week and this week now. That's 9 interceptions in this 2-game stretch, and we're not done here.
It's almost like they can't even believe their eyes. Or maybe, is the confidence level in him so high that they believe they'll get out of it and make plays for them to win a game?
Well, they've said they believe in it. That's being tested right here. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10. Now a handoff to start it out. Robinson. And he finds some space. Pass to 25 for 27. 140 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. Running out of the gun with ETN. And he's able to take this one up to the 45-yard line. Vision and speed, two of the attributes that you might say are important for a free safety, and we saw both in evidence there.
And sometimes all of your best laid plans of play design, your X's and O's, they can't always account for individual effort defensively. And this was one of those times. Just a terrific play to hustle over there and get the running back to the ground.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They run. Robinson. Gets a pickup of 4 and it'll bring up 2nd down. So this will be a win for Jacksonville. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I bet halftime is really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense that it was much more of the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got
actually
it together,
pretty well,
got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in a second.
Yeah, we didn't do that one, unfortunately. don't want to know. No offense to the guy. We're gonna do these now. So let's have a look with this. With our Asian.
Oh. Hey, just so you know, I talked with the Nike rep the other day. They're really pleased with the partnership so far. Even though there have been some struggles on the field, general interest and sales figures have exceeded their expectations. Honestly, we're in a good place.
Yo, this is great.
Why do we look like that? On here, we look I feel like we look different on here than we do in like cutscenes. Is that just me eyes playing tricks on me? I mean, charity is a major thing. I should be able to help out, especially when you're in like something as good as like the NFL, where you probably get paid loads. Which I'm not surprised. It's fun to play. It's fun to watch. But yeah, I'm gonna do these in the next episode. So if you do like this video, make sure to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Basically tells you each time I upload a video. But until next time, adios.